Cause you been acting different lately, girl. What's on your mind?
Hey YouTube, it is your girl Amanda back with another freaking video. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how I do beach waves to my hair, but with a really simple, easy method. Because I know when I was trying to learn this to my hair, it literally took me forever because nothing was working. First, I have really, really long hair. I have really thick hair and none of the curls would hold and it would, sorry y'all, I have my fan on. The curls would fall out in like 5 seconds. So I finally found a method that works for me and I hope that works for you as well. So I'm gonna share it with you guys. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so for the first, to begin this hairstyle, you're gonna wanna put your hair up in a high ponytail. So literally it doesn't matter if it's messy, straight, whatever. Just put it up in a high ponytail and it can look really crazy, it can look really good. It just does not matter. So, boom. Wait, I'm about to do this 3 times. I have really thick hair, so like if hair ties go 3 times on my hair, you know they're good. So that's why I like using these scrunchies, because they go 3 times around my wonderful head. So, boom. Also, I do recommend when you like doing this on freshly clean hair and have it blow drying, but don't blow dry it to where it's completely straight. Blow dry it upside down and kind of tease it a little bit. It makes your curls more bouncier and whatnot. So if you're doing this on flat ironed hair, and I know my hair looks flat ironed, it's not, but it's not gonna come out as pretty. So I have my flat iron here. I have it on a, not flat iron, I have my curling iron here. I have it on 400. And we're about to start getting into it. So, reason why I say put your hair up in a ponytail like this is because it makes the sections a lot easier to do. Especially if you have thick hair. Trust me, I know you struggle. You're not gonna, you know, curling your hair takes like 35 hours, okay? Like literally curling long, thick hair takes too freaking long. So, yes. So first you're just gonna want to take a part of your hair, put the other part on the other side of your head, and this is the part that you're going to be curling to begin with. So spray it with some heat protectant, just a little bit, not too much. You don't want to get it wet so then you burn your hair off. I do have bangs, so my hair looks like I'm doing it wrong. So when you take your wand, you're going to want to wrap it from the back of your head. A lot of people mistaken you and they go around like this. You're not going to want to do that. You're going to want to, you're gonna wanna go from here, go to the back of the hair, like so, and wrap it around backwards, because that gives it, like, you know, the, like, in the front, it's gonna look bouncier and whatnot. Wrap it around and go like this. Kind of tilt it, like, not down, but, like, tilt it down. You know what I mean? So, hold it for, like, I hold it for, like, 10 or 15 seconds. This is an arm workout, y'all. When... So while we're sitting here waiting, I'm about to speak. I'm about to just like talk to while I'm doing this, because yeah, this is common. It's kind of like common sense. Hold it. Then when you let it go, just let it go in your hair. Don't let it fully fall out yet. Just let it fall into your hand. Put your flat iron down. Take you some hairspray. Hold it there for a second. And spray the hairspray as you let the curl down. And it's gonna look like so. Looks like a, I don't even know what it looks like. So yeah, you just basically do that throughout your whole head. It's really not that hard, but, and also other tip is, if you want, like, if you want your curls to come out more like fuller and looser, do smaller sections. Or if you want your curls to come out more together and like not as many, do bigger sections. I like, personally, I like smaller sections. No, it's not gonna look like this when I take this out. You're gonna brush them out and everything, but just keep that in mind. If you want like more curls in your hair or more beach waves, do smaller sections, because you're gonna get I forgot to spray. You're gonna get more curls out of a smaller section. It might take longer, but I like it. Some days though, I do bigger sections because I'd be lazy or I'd be in a rush. So, boop. Anyways, so are y'all going back to school? Because I'm not. I just got told by my district that I won't be going back to school till January. Possibly, I might not even go back this whole year. They don't know what's going on with the schools. They don't know how to give us back to school. And I'm seeing all this stuff that kids are going back to school. And I'm like, sis, I really do wish that I could go back to school. I miss school so much. Like, I never thought me leaving March 15th was going to be like a forever type thing. It feels like forever, literally. Yeah, and then just let it go. But yeah, so I'm not going back to school and it kind of sucks. And everybody's talking about going back to school. And I'm like, oh, well, must be nice because your girl's not going back to school. Like, oh my God. It honestly is heartbreaking though, like how fast life can change. And on top of that, I have no sports right now. And I'm super involved in my school with cheer and everything. So this is just great, you know? I don't even know. It's just terrible. But like, everyone always tells me the world is going through a lot right now. Like, we have to bear with it and everything. But like, I completely understand that. Trust me, I know I'm super happy that I'm healthy and all that. But it's still a simple fact that like, I still have a life, you know? Like, I still supposed to be going to school. I'm going into 11th grade. I'm not learning what I'm supposed to. I don't even know. This is just too crazy for me, for real. So if y'all going back to school, let me know down in the comments, because I wish. Let me know so I can come to y'all school, because I want to go back to school. I don't care where. I just want to be in a classroom. I know that sounds crazy, like I hate school, but yeah. So anyways, this is what it looks like. Kind of cute. And just do this throughout your whole head, like for real. This might take me a little bit because I'm doing my whole head, but yeah. So I'm gonna do probably like two more on camera, and then I'm going to fast forward this because I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna wanna like, you know, watch me for like an hour doing this. Also, other thing is, if you have a smaller wand, so like how my wand is like bigger on the top and then go skinnier to the bottom, I don't know if it works for this method because it is a smaller barrel, so your curl comes out smaller. So I don't know. You can try it though. I don't see why it wouldn't. It just might take you a little longer or it might not come out as poofy. I don't know. Definitely try it though. I don't have a smaller wand. I just use this big one. Boom. So that is how it's supposed to come out. I'm about to fast forward this a little bit for you guys and show y'all what it looks like towards the middle. Okay, so update. I got a little bit further. This is so tiring. This is the one thing I can say about this. My arms be like ready to die. Okay, so I have all this hair left, but then again, like I said, if you don't want it to be like this long or nothing, you could definitely make the pieces smaller or whatever, I mean bigger. But I'm just picky, I guess. I don't know. But yeah, well, you know what I was just thinking, guys? Like, I really need some video ideas. So if y'all have some video ideas down below, like beauty videos y'all want to see, or like I look muscles, let me know so I could do them, because I really want to do some more beauty videos, you know? Like, I got my vanity. So if y'all want to see a specific video, let me know, because I will do it. Okay, I really want to start doing more beauty videos, because I am really into beauty, but I just don't, I'm like stuck on what to do for videos. So if y'all have some video, if y'all have some video suggestions, please comment that.
Okay, so this is what it should look like right now. It looks kind of crazy because my ponytail is to the side, but this is what it looks like right now. I promise y'all it's not going to look like this when you take it out. So once you're done curling it, go ahead and take the ponytail out. And yeah, just rip the ponytail out, let it sit. Now it's going to be stuck there. I flip my head upside down. Hold on, let me get up out of this chair so y'all can see me. And just go like this. Boop. Flip up. And boom. You have your curly, wavy, bouncy curls that are so pretty. Oh my goodness. Oh, I love it. Let me sit back in my chair so I can show y'all what to do now. So, what? Sorry, I'm not that tall, so it takes me a minute to get back up in this chair. All right, so once you got your curls out and everything, you're either gonna wanna find your part or flip it over to the side. Most of the time when I curl my hair like this, I have it flipped to the side like so. But sometimes I like finding my part so I could split it right down the middle. But if you want to split it down the middle, you can. But I'm gonna leave it like this. Then just spray some hairspray and boom. You have your curly beachy waves and they're so pretty. So good. So, yes, that is how I do my wave, my curls like this. I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe down below. Please, 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 please subscribe so you can see more of me. I really hope you guys, this method worked for you. If it did, please comment down below and tell me. Yes. Follow me on all my social medias, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!